Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, we learn a method for doing unit conversions, and we do the following four problems. We're going to work on a way to do conversions from one kind of a unit to another. So here's an example. Convert 8 feet to inches. That's asking how many inches are in 8 feet. So there are many ways to do this, but I'm going to give you a method that will work for anything. So here's the idea. You have to see, first of all, you've got like 8 feet. And the question is, you want your answer to be in inches. All right, so what could we do here? Well, we want to see if we know anything about the relationship between a foot and an inch. All right, so hopefully you know this, that there are 12 inches is equal to 1 foot. Okay, now if these two things are equal, then from algebra you could divide both sides by the same thing. So I could divide both sides by, let's say, 1 foot, right? Dividing both sides by the same thing. But notice, 1 foot divided by 1 foot is really the same thing as the number 1. So you know what? This right here is another way of writing the number 1. Now, what if instead of dividing by 1 foot, I had 12 inches equals 1 foot? How about instead I divided both sides by 12 inches? Okay, well, again, 12 inches divided by 12 inches equals 1, so there's another way of writing the number 1. That's the guiding principle that I'm going to use in this method for conversions. I know there's more than one method, but this is just one way of doing it. So here's the idea. We've got 8 feet, and I want to end up with inches. So I've got a foot in the numerator. I have to multiply by something where I'm going to have a foot in the denominator and an inches in the numerator. So you have to think, well, do I want to do it 12 inches over 1 foot? Or 1 foot over 12 inches, which makes sense, so that the feet will cancel and the inches will be in the numerator. It must be this one right here. So I'm going to multiply this 12 inches over 1 foot by 8 feet. All right, so what I've got right here is 12 inches over 1 foot. That's like multiplying by 1. So what happens? Well, notice foot and foot cancels. So I end up with what? 8 times 12 inches. And most of you probably could have done that without going through this, because most of us know if you've got feet, all you have to do is multiply by 12 to get it in inches. But the reason I'm going over a simple example is because we're going to be working with some problems where it's not quite so obvious what the answer is going to be. You might not be able to do it in your head. So here's the principle. If you have something in one unit, you want to multiply by a fraction so that the denominators are canceled. Okay? You'll have the right unit in the numerator. And sometimes this takes more than one step. So let's go on to another problem. All right, we want to convert 8 inches to centimeters. Now, that's something that you may not know, that there is a conversion. And the most common one used is that 1 inch is approximately 2.54 centimeters. So in other words, an inch is about 2.5 centimeters. Now, this is not exact. That's why I have a squiggly equal sign here. So let's do this problem, starting off with 8 inches. And I know it's not going to be exact when I multiply it by, what am I going to now multiply this by? Right, what can I multiply that by so that my answer will end up in centimeters? Okay, Well, we're going to take this conversion and 1 inch over 2.54 centimeters, that's going to equal 1, or 2.54 centimeters over 1 inch, right? Because they're equal to each other, you could just put one of them in the numerator and the other one in the denominator because we know they're actually equal to each other. And they're not exactly equal to each other, right? This is approximately. So let's see. I need to get centimeters, so I need to use this. So I'm going to write 2.54 centimeters over 1 inch. And that way my inches will cancel. And I'm going to put a little squiggly line because, it's not exactly equal, but it's pretty darn close. So now we just have to do 8 times 2.54, which is 20.32 centimeters. Now, a problem may ask you to round to a certain place, and if so, then of course you would do that. But in this case, we'll just leave it. That's what we get when we approximate it. If we wanted to know to the nearest centimeter, then that would be 20 centimeters, for instance. If it was to the nearest tenth, 20.3 centimeters, etc. All right, here's our next problem. Convert 2 miles to yards. Okay, this is a little bit tricky. There is no direct miles to yards conversion that I know of, but you could look up to find out how many feet are in a mile. And actually, this is it. 1 mile equals 5,280 feet. 5,280 feet. Okay. Well, okay, so I could see how I might go from miles to feet, but I need to get to yards. So there's something else we have to notice here is that is there some way of getting from feet to yards? And we know that 3 feet is 1 yard, or you could say 1 yard equals 3 feet. So these are the two equations we need to use when we're going to go from miles to yards. So let's start out with what we know. We've got 2 miles, and I have to multiply that by some fraction to get the miles to cancel out, and I'm going to have to multiply it by something else to end up finally getting it in yards. So remember, the goal is to get this in only yards. Okay, so let's see. I can use this first one here. Now, what would I do? Would I put 5,280 feet over 1 mile or 1 mile over 5,280 feet? And you've got to make sure the miles cancel. So you want that 1 mile in the denominator, okay, which means the 5,280 feet is in the numerator. Now remember what this means. This is the number one because 5,280 feet actually equals a mile, so it's like you're writing a number over exactly the same number. It's just that you see it written differently because one happens to be in feet and the other one happens to be in miles. All right, now, so you see how I'm going to get those miles to cancel? So that's great, but now I'm going to have an answer in feet. But I want my answer in yards. So now I have to look at the second one. 1 yard is 3 feet. I want the feet to cancel, so I want to have a feet in the denominator to cancel with something. So I want the 3 feet in the denominator. So what would go in the numerator? That's the same thing as 1 yard, so I could write 1 yard in the numerator. All right, so now I've got my feet to cancel, and you see how you'll end up getting something in yards. So the last thing is to actually do the division here, 5,280 divided by 3, right? So you would have, first of all, the 5,280 divided by 3. And if it goes in evenly, no problem. I think this does go in evenly because if you add the digits up here, 5, 2, and 8, that's 15. Remember, if the digits of a number add up to something 3 goes into, then 3 will go into the big number as well. So you could just do this in your calculator, 5,280 divided by 3, and we're going to get our answer is 1,760 yards. Now, if it did not go in evenly, then you would be rounding it to some number. And if you weren't given what number to round to, then I couldn't tell you what the best one to round to is. But you might be told to round it to the nearest yard or to the nearest tenth of a yard, etc. Okay, so we've done that one. Let's try one more. Okay, let's convert 450 centimeters to feet and round our answer to the nearest tenth of a foot and use the conversion 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters. All right, why don't you put the video on pause and try this on your own first? Okay, hopefully you put it on pause and tried it. So let's see. We start off with 450 centimeters, and in the end, I want my answer to be in feet. So first I need to get rid of the centimeters, and I'm going to use this conversion that 1 inch is the same thing as 2.54 centimeters. So I can cancel out the centimeters, but I've got my answer in inches. And I want my answer in feet, so I have to use another conversion. So you think, well, what do I know about feet and inches? I know that 12 inches equals 1 foot. So let's see. I want the inches to cancel, so I need 12 inches in the denominator and 1 foot in the numerator. Now I'll be able to cancel the inches in the inches, so hopefully you see your answer will be in feet. All right, but what do I have here? Let's say I've got 450 left in the numerator. Right, and I have 2.54 times 12 in the denominator. So first I'm just going to put the 450 over, and let's do 2.54 times 12 in our calculators or by hand. And that's 30.48 feet. And now what we're going to do is divide and round to the nearest tenth. So we want to put 450 divided by 30.48, and if we round to the nearest tenth, you should have 14.8 feet for your answer. Right, so what we've done in this first video on conversions is we're just using this particular method where we're multiplying by fractions so that the numerator and denominator are the same thing, but we're just using different units in each. But they're actually equal to each other, ex or approximately equal to each other. There are other ways to do it, of course, but this is just one method that you can use for unit conversions. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.